In my time, two chairmen of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, who is the senior military manager of the United States, asked my permission to sit in the captain's chair. I know because I had letters from them, vice chancellors of great universities who organized their schedules around episodes. But the most charming was when I discovered, when I was working in Washington on the Othello, that the then Secretary of State, Madeleine Albright, was a huge fan of the series. I got to know her and we became friends. She was in Los Angeles when we were filming the last movie, which included a wedding ceremony, Commander Riker and Deanna Troi, and we were all in our dress uniforms. Madeleine visited the set that day, and she had her photograph taken with the seven of us, the officers of the Enterprise, and Madeleine standing in the middle. I'm told that she likes to take people, guess who is the alien in this photo? and sometime later, I went to visit her in her office. She now runs a private company in Washington. Her assistant was showing us around and showing us all of these wonderful items of memorabilia that over the years, the Secretary of State, she had been given. And then we came to the door of her office, and on one side of the door was a photograph of the Clinton cabinets with Secretary Albright sitting next to the President. And on the other side was the photograph of Secretary Albright with the seven members. And her assistant said, can you guess which is the one she most proudly points out?
I have to say, and I'm sure there are many people in the audience who are huge Star Trek fans as well, but I've been a Trekkie fan for years, and I actually sat in the captain's chair when it was brought to Hyde Park the year before last in that wonderful Star Trek exhibition that they had there. So I can quite understand why they want to do it. It's an incredible power to be.
You know, the first one was just a chair, it was just made. You know, by the way, we had four chairs stolen during this. Yeah, they're big. You had to unbolt them. We got them off the set and off the lot and out there. From the second season on, I had a customized chair. It wasn't the same chair for the first one. I mean, they measured my arms and they measured my legs. So it really only fitted me.
Have you got it?
No, I do not. No, I couldn't afford it.
Actually, just one final thought on that when you were talking about the uniforms. You couldn't put on any weight in those things, could you? I mean, they would show every lump of bulge.
They did. Well, in the early days, yes, because we wore spandex for two seasons. And then, thanks to my chiropractor in Los Angeles, it was changed to wool. Because the spandex was all the costumes were made one size too small. So you had to press against the spandex in order to stand up properly. And that smoothed out all the wrinkles, which was the look that Gene Roddenberry wanted. But it was very bad for the scalp.
And you haven't got a costume either.
Well, you know,
could afford that.
I offered to buy one. They went to wouldn't sell me one. My colleague Stewart, they didn't help themselves, and I could never quite bring myself to do that. But I appeared on a chat show in California about 18 months ago, and somehow this had got around that the series was over, everything was done, and the only person who didn't have a uniform was myself. And they walked on set with one of my own Picard uniforms. They had called Rick Bowman, the executive producer, and said, you know, this is a shocking disgrace, you can't allow this to happen. So they actually gave me one. Do I have a wear? This house actually had a front door right onto the street. None of the others had. And all my friends knew this. So when Halloween came out, they said, oh, you're, for the first time, people are going to be knocking on the door. And they said, you've got to be prepared. So I was warned about having a tray of chocolates and goodies and things. And indeed, it did happen. And I was prepared. And children came to the door. One knock I answered, and the door was open. And there was a four-year-old boy wearing my uniform.
Oh.
And his father said, oh, hi, Rip. He was just wearing a Halloween costume, didn't he?
Oh, my God.
Look at Andy, maybe this year, October 31st.
You mean mine will be? I shall go around.